this. There was another UFO sighting in Green Bay last night.
Whoa. Hey, that's just like the book I'm reading. It's this true story about this dude who gets kidnapped by aliens from outer space.
Wow. Why would they want to kidnap someone?
Well, simple, dude. They're searching for signs of intelligent life to take back to their planet.
Well, I guess you two won't be going anywhere.
Morning, everybody.
Oh, morning, honey.
Hi.
Carol, do you believe in aliens like Cody does?
No. Come on, Cody, you don't really believe they're aliens, do you?
Sure. Hey, how else do you explain all the mysteries of the universe, like the Bermuda Triangle, or Stonehenge, or Velcro?
Come on, Brandon, I'll walk you to school. Bye, everybody.
Bye. Bye. Okay, have a good day. Bye-bye.
Man spends 2 years in spaceship, marries alien queen. Please.
Bye, honey. Bye-bye, girls.
Bye, Mom. Karen, this book has inspired me. How would you like to help me trick Cody and JT into thinking they saw a real UFO?
What for?
To humiliate them and make them look like complete fools.
Oh. Cool. Count me in.
Dad, I can't believe you're going through with this.
JT, Carol and I have had no time alone together since we got married. We really need this weekend away.
I don't care if you go away, but do you have to put Dana in charge?
Do you have a better idea?
Yeah, put me in charge.
JT, I said, do you have a better idea?
Okay, Dana, now here's a list of phone numbers you might need in case of emergency. Our hotel in Milwaukee, the Bauman's next door, Dr. Kipper, Dr. Sharp.
Don't forget Dr. Beasley.
Dr. Beasley? The veterinarian?
Yes. What if JT gets sick?
Or if we have to put Dana to sleep.
Come on, honey, we gotta go.
Now, I just want you two to have a wonderful time, and don't worry about us for a minute. Although, I'll miss you terribly. You are such a suck-up. Hey, you go with your strength.
Now, kids, you know, this is the first time that we've left you alone, and I am trusting you to behave yourselves. That means listen to Dana, okay?
Okay.
All right, bye.
Oh, oh,
jeez.
Oh,
gosh.
Oh, gosh.
Oh, 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 okay. Oh,
well, right. Bye.
Okay, here we are. Bye-bye. Oh, and one more thing. No parties while we're gone.
Don't worry, Carol. You can trust us.
Okay, bye.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
It's party time! Yeah!
Yeah! Hey, little cuz. Why the long face?
My friend Billy has the chicken pox. And he can't play with me.
Oh, serious bummer. You know what'll cheer you up? One of my world-famous homemade ice cream sandwiches.
All right!
What are you guys doing?
Oh, I'm making Brendan one of my world-famous ice cream sandwiches. You want one?
Ice cream sandwich? Yeah, that does sound pretty good.
You want rye or whole wheat? I got sourdough. Hey, dude.
Cold mail, what's that?
Oh, it's called Eye of the Tiger cologne. Lady at the store said it drives women wild.
You're gonna try it on Dana, right?
You got it.
What is that smell? It reminds me of something. Something earthy. Something almost animalistic.
This stuff is righteous, man. Looks like the chase is over.
I would blame it on the dog, but we don't have one.
Goes another 350 down the drain.
Al, you got a great band. Now, all you need is a cool name. How about Chicks with Attitude?
Yeah!
How about Chicks with No Talent?
Dana, talent's not that important. What this band needs is something that will move the audience, that will touch them in a special way. You need
better clothes.
Karen's got a point, Al. All the big groups hire fashion consultants.
Could we hire you, Karen?
I'm sorry. I made a vow never to use my fashion gift for financial gain.
Guys, we don't need a fashion consultant. What we need is a gig.
You guys are 12 years old. Where are you gonna get a gig, Mr. Rogers' neighborhood?
What you kids really need is a manager. Someone who knows how to mold a career. Someone hip and cool. Someone like me.
What a crock. I've never heard so much hot air.
Me neither. We gotta hire this guy.
Smart move. You guys are gonna be hot. Stick with me, you'll be working big stadiums.
Oh, yeah. Big stadiums. I can hear you guys now. Peanuts here! Hey, get your peanuts here!
So there's this rad bolt of lightning, and the old dude sits up in his coffin, and he's really hungry, because he hasn't eaten since they buried him. And you know what he likes to eat best? Little kids. There he is, right behind you. No, right there.
Give it up, Cody. That wasn't even scary.
Well, you guys are little. I didn't want to freak you out.
Well, you didn't. I'm going to bed. Night, Cody.
Yeah, thanks for a bedtime story, Codeman. Night.
Well, I'm glad I didn't scare you. Ghost stories. What a kick. Yeah. Hey, you guys, wait up.
Goes in your left.
Your other left.
Your other left?
What's the difference? Frank's kids eat with their hands anyway.
Hey, I heard that hairball.
Could we just can the wisecracks for 5 minutes? Is that too much to ask?
Get real, Frank. 5 minutes? The record is 1:45, and that was at Aunt Becky's funeral.
Hi, everybody.
Hi.
Something smells good.
Lambert stew.
You're cooking. What's the occasion?
I think he hit a possum on his way home from work.
All right, come on, honey, sit down. Everybody, dinner's almost ready. Let's go wash up. Come on, come on. Let's go, let's go.
Are we really having possum?
Dream on. That's only for Christmas.
Hey, he's coming, he's coming. Everybody hide.
Were you surprised?
Totally. I didn't even know it was my birthday. Dude, how old am I?
19.
19? What happened to 16 through 18?
Hi, Mom. How's it going?
Oh, not so good, Dana. I'm really worried about Frank. You know, Saturday's his 40th birthday.
What are you worried about? That'll make those funny little party hats in his eyes?
Dana, I'm serious. I'm just afraid that turning 40 could send Frank into a midlife crisis. That's why I'm reading this book.
Your man at 40, when his inner child needs changing. Mom, you promised to lay off the pop psychology.
I know, but just listen. It says here that when a man turns 40, he's beset by self-doubt and the realization of his own mortality.
Mom, this is Frank we're talking about. I think he'll be more upset about the party hats.
Dana, I'm concerned. According to this book, men often attempt to recapture their youth by acting out their adolescent fantasies, like having an affair with a younger woman or buying a flashy sports car.
Mom, I think you're overreacting. It just doesn't sound like Frank.
Oh, hi, honey. I just came from the auto show. Check out that Ferrari.
You're buying a new sports car, aren't you?
No, don't be silly, honey. I can't afford a sports car.
Can't afford to have an affair either.
Is that a psychology book you're reading?
Well, Frank, get ready for another session of Ask Dr. Carol.
Look, Frank, I know you frown on psychology.
Yeah, honey, I don't frown on psychology. I just think it's a lot of crap.
But you're turning 40. That can be very traumatic.
Carol, I'm fine with turning 40. Life is great. I'm a lucky guy.
Oh, don't you see what you're doing? You're in denial.
No, I'm not.
Oh, it's worse than I thought. You're in denial about your denial.
You're right, Carol. I can't face turning 40. The very thought of it has me emotionally paralyzed. What's for dinner?
Frank, you know, when a man turns 40, he often looks back over his life and feels frustrated about the things that he hasn't accomplished in his life. Now, looking back, what things haven't you accomplished?
There is one thing, but it's too late now.
No, it's never too late. What dreams haven't you fulfilled?
Well, honey, I always wanted to meet the Three Stooges. Not Curly Joe, the original three, Larry, Moe, and Curly. And Shep would have been okay, but they're all dead now. Did you know that Curly and Moe were brothers?
Frank. I'm talking about some kind of challenge, like skydiving or mountain climbing. I mean, certainly there must be some exciting thing you regret not doing.
When I was 18, I wanted to get a pilot's license. But that phase passed.
No. The experts say you've got to get these things out of your system. So, this is great. For your birthday, I am going to get you flying lessons.
If it makes you happy. I just wanted a party with some funny hats, though.
Come on, boy. You can do it. One step at a time.
Perhaps stair climbing is not instinctual to the porcine family.
No, a bullet can learn this. Pigs are very smart animals.
True. Perhaps you just have an unusually stupid one.
Hey, you can call me stupid. You can call my family stupid. But lay off the pig.
You're right. Pigs are smart. Studies have shown if an animal is unable to learn, the fault lies with the trainer.
Oh, really? Let me show you how good of a trainer I am. If you're not upstairs in the next 3 seconds, I'm gonna make your nose look just like Bullet's. Bye. There. Now see how easy that was?